All right, thank you very much, Rich. So, this is it. There's been a lot of talk, there's been a lot of discussion, but I think we're finally going to be able to get into the match. So, guys, Bardolf has made a couple of points here saying that you guys actually have some opinions you want to add, at least as far as the maps are going to play out and who's favored on what. So, DDK, I'm going to throw it to you first.
Yeah, he's talking directly about the Dust 2 stuff, and it's actually quite funny because that specifically, we've seen Cloud9 actually take from TSM's book with that, the triple deep play into B as CTs, and that is really, really strong. You can kind of trick your opponents. Now, that's kind of weird, using TSM stuff against TSM. I don't think I've seen that actually happen before, so that could be quite fun.
Yeah, and I want this to be a good grand final. However, I feel like TSM might just run away with this. The styles of the team, I think this is a team that really fits for TSM style. They play very, very disciplined, and it's going to be very, very hard for a player like Skadoodle, for example. You can hear Anders talked with Kerrigan. He said the same thing. They're going to have an easy time to shut down a player like Skadoodle.
Yeah, that they have the experience, and it's going to come down to whether the three stars on both teams really can measure up one against another. Who's going to win those duels? And to start things off on Cash in particular, a lot of the time, you know, it's that mid-control, it's those fights, it's that opera going against the other one, and who's going to come out ahead? Skadoodle, he faced up well versus JW, but then you've got, like, what, four oppers on TSM? So somebody's going to step up there to take on Ska.
Yeah, caches are always a really interesting one because it always seems like, you know, it's such an American map, to be honest. Mm-hmm. They always seem so comfortable there and they always pull out the rounds. So it's actually a really good map to start Cloud9 off with. And I'm very curious how that's actually going to pan out, whether Skadoodle's going to get going on it or not, because I feel like the tone's really going to get set on even the first half of the first map here on Cash. So Cloud9, they're definitely going to be pulling for that CT start, but TSM are pretty solid there. However, we know how badly it can go for a team once they start to get money screwed on the CT side.
Oh, that's true. And my Big Spoon made a big point as well. The fact that if you win that pistol, you manage to actually remove the op early on, unless the team plays for that op. So we'll have to see. Both of these teams, they've shown that they're willing to hold off on that force buy in the second round in order to get better gear in the fourth round buy. So that's something that we're going to have to keep in mind here. Whoever wins that pistol, that op is going to be of all important, rather.
Yeah, it's very annoying to rely on an AWP on a map like Cash because it's very easy to win rounds on a low buy. So if you heavily rely on an AWP like Skadoodle, if you're going for the low buy, you're just not going to fit your style.
This is actually quite an interesting point as well because one of the edges that Cloud9 had against Fnatic was that they picked up Mirage straight away. But how did they pick up Mirage straight away? It was actually the fact that we saw the force buy coming out from Fnatic, and this was a play that Cloud9 was so comfortable in dealing with, and they got Fnatic off to a terrible start. They played it perfectly, and that having that start really just, I mean, allowed them to get such a huge lead. And this is the thing, TSM don't usually do those kinds of economical plays. So, well, here we go.
This is it. TSM and Cloud9. This is it, the grand finals, the first map. DreamHack Valencia powered by FaZe, and we get straight into the pistol round between TSM and Cloud9, and already a battle at mid. Kerrigan starting us off strong with a headshot, removing nothing from the map. The hero essentially from Train for Cloud9, and he's just won't stop. He's actually picking up all the frags right now. Finally, Skadoodle can actually shut somebody down, but it's going to be Dupree at the back of B site holding the line here for the Danes, and Kerrigan rotates in a third kill for him before they can finally take him out. Shroud now in a 1v3, and this is looking definitely a bit touch and go for him. He's caught in the Triangle of Doom, and they're going to flank him out. Zitrix with the final kill, but a very fast round here to start the pistol.
Cloud9 trying something cool there. We're dropping two P250s and trying just to go for the aim duels in mid. However, there were no one to peek them in mid, so they tried to go for the B-split, and then it just got shut down.
Yeah, I mean, that looks absolutely chaotic. I really like the fast pace in there from Cloud9, but pistol rounds, they always come down to hitting the shots. It's as simple as that. And now we will see them going for the force up here onto the second round to try to reclaim something and do some damage to TSM.
And nothing, taking the first bullet to the face as well. Pretty much one of the strongest pistol players in the world right now. Definitely a big ace for Cloud9. The fact that he got nailed by Kerrigan right off the bat definitely hurt Cloud9's odds in that round, but we'll see how they pan out here in the second round. They have elected to go for the buy, Cloud9, and again, going for the boost, and there's the flick from Ska. Not going to get the edge, instead it's Kerrigan, there it is! Follow-up shot, and Ska trades one for one.
This is really interesting, actually. We have Sean Gez, he's got invested in a smoke and a Molotov. What do you think he's going to use this for threat? What's the plan?
I think it's going to be a B execute. It looks like three guys is close to Schmidt, so it might actually be a split here. It's very risky to do that with only Tech-9s.
I think they're relying on Scott maybe to catch TSM out somewhere, but TSM are playing this very carefully. Two over on the A side, two over on B, and not really showing anything, not really giving a free kill over to Cloud9.
They're actually going back right now towards A after showing some presence towards mid and B, and TSM, they're actually a little bit weak on A. If Cloud9 actually get a fast entry, This is looking very dangerous for TSM, and they still have the Molotov and the smoke. They could be so key. There's the smoke thrown by Sean Gez. There's a second player in place now for TSM. This could get crazy.
But Device with the spray down, he manages to pick up the first one. Freakazoid annihilates Zipnix on that site, though. No time wasted. And Skadoodle already going to get one tag on a Device, dropping him low. Device does return with the kill, however. That's a man advantage now for TSM going into this retake. Keep in mind, Cloud9, the man with the rifle is low, and Sean Gez only has a Tech 9 to hold off this push, but there are no nades to make this easier.
Yeah, this is looking really, really labored at the moment. Dupree comes in from A main with the P90. Great coordination there from the Danes. They'll pick up the defuse, and they save the round, but bomb down. Few kills. You actually mentioned previously Cloud9 are a team that are so consistently getting the bomb plant and the damage in a round like this, in a match like this, it's so key.
I wonder if they will actually force buy again and just maybe go for a straight up A execute with Tech 9 armor and smokes.
Not out of the cards. I mean, they want to keep that pressure up. They're doing damage. They only got the two kills in that round, so I mean, it's still kind of on the edge. If they'd have got a third, they could really force TSM into an awkward spot regarding the money, but still, TSM suffering some losses. We'll see how that impacts the next round coming up here and what Cloud9 have in store for us. We have a bit of a pause here, so it allows us already to start evaluating how the beginning of this map is played out.
Yeah, I think everything's going to be on this round right here, because I really expect Cloud9 to go for that execute. It can take form in many, many different ways. It could be Wall of Smokes into a B-split. It could just be a straight-up A execute. They could actually try to go for the A execute with a fake and go and then go into mid into an A-split or a B-split. There's actually loads of options for executes in this map. If this is Envious, they're always doing it. I think Cloud9 will have the plays in the book. So
yeah, considering Sean Gez had a Molotov and a smoke that round towards the B-site, maybe yeah. They have a plan with the Molotovs towards that site. It would be really cool to see a full-on Molotov execute towards B is something that we haven't seen a lot of. I've seen it a few times, but it's actually really, really strong. You can actually, with only three Molotovs, you can block off the entire B site.
Yeah, you need to get control of those B halls and basically lock it down. But if they can get an entry, if Skadoodle can deliver once again, or at least trade effectively in mid, maybe you stack one of your players, but if Ska's there to bring it back, you can keep that pressure up. And TSM already showing that they're not willing to peek out once they have suffered losses. They did play that last round very far back towards the sites, but we will not have a force buy in this round. Instead, Cloud9 electing to play a bit more economically minded here, perhaps thinking about Skadoodles off in the next round.
Yeah, I actually like this from Cloud9 as well. You don't have to go for the execute. You don't have to follow up the investment. They're going to kind of go a little bit halfway, see what they can get done with some pistols and a few grenades on Sean Gez. Now, with a fast headshot or two, they could get another bomb down, improve their economic situation. And once again, the pressure's on, and TSM are in place to deal with this. And here they go, already lining up for Zipnix, as he is just still by port. They're trying to challenge him, but without the pop flashes, it's very difficult. He's going to get multiple kills, and he is wrecking them. Great response from Zipnix. That is a clean hold on the site, and that is a lot of money in the bank for TSM.
Yeah, excellent defense there from Zipnix. I like the try, though, from Cloud9, just trying to use a smoke and two flashes to get that bomb plant. But just look at this from Zipnix.
This is a thing of beauty. This is such a difficult situation. He has to hit every shot dead on, three headshots in a row. That's how it's done. So difficult to deal with Zipnix when he's on point, and that's why, I mean, he's kind of a snake in the grass, Zipnix. You don't really see him as the flash player, but then he's so far up there in the stats with TSM, doing damage consistently. But now, we get into the thick of things, and Freakazoid once again rushes straight out in mid and takes out Kerrigan.
TSM might have to use Cage and B straight into the vent as a response, but this is really hard. Oh, he's going to go in, but Skadoodle's got the angle. He's going to go straight down, and Cloud9, they're going to put that pace on middle. I love this test into middle, just to put the pressure on TSM to ask questions. Hey, are you going to play that 1-3-1? If you're playing 2-1-2, we're taking mid, and there's nothing you can do about it. Right here, we have three players there for TSM. So do they go for a gamble? Do they stack a site? Or yep. Do they go for the save? What are they looking for?
They have to go for the stack here. They can't win a 3v5 with spreading out.
Well, at least Zipnix manages to trade one for one there effectively, but it's still a two-man advantage here for Cloud9. Device needs to come in big. He needs to hit an instant headshot, but that's just not going to happen, especially now that Cloud9 have established themselves on this site. Skadoodle holding that long line into CT. And, well, unfortunately, Dupree was not counting on Sean Gez lurking out in mid. So this has definitely turned towards Cloud9, at least in this crucial round. And Sean just barely hanging in there. Device needs to get in here. He actually needs to get some damage on Cloud9. It would be big if he could drop a gun.
Yeah, it's actually, I feel like unlike TSM to say, okay, we can split up one player per section of the map to actually go for that instead of just going for a three-man save.
Wow, okay, there we go.
But damage in, that's going to be nice. But still, really good round from Cloud9. And again, I just have to say, I absolutely love the fact they just go in mid straight away because I mean, it's a bit of a gamble, but if you actually get that 2-1-2 setup, you're going to have a round like this.
Yeah, it's a very, very good strat there by Cloud9. They know TSM usually boosts the event, I think, at least if they watch some demos, which means they have an early timing where they can separate the players defending mid. They just killed the guy coming from Cedar Connector, and then you saw three players aiming towards that vent.
Well, here's Cloud9's big opportunity now to take a lot of momentum in this match. TSM clearly on the ropes, a bit of a force on their side. P90, only a CZ75 on Cajun, and they're rushing forward to control here. The flashes are ringing out, however, and Cloud9 go barreling into mid. There's one quick frag. Not gonna happen with the second, though. Cajun, just a pistol. Pistol gets two kills.
This is looking absolutely crazy right now. KGB's gonna go straight in, but Device is still there holding it down. But no! By the sandbags, he's going to fall. Nothing in with a shot straight to the head. And now it's Zimnix against three players. Oh, that nade is perfect. There's the frag. Two more players left, but Skadoodle says no. He's gonna take the shot with the AWP. He's gonna connect. And Cloud9 win another round.
Skadoodle challenges again.
I was just gonna say, Skadoodle challenges in that position. His teammate Nothing had 10 HP. If he missed that shot, the round is almost over.
That guy's a monster. It's like I was saying, man, he didn't come here to mess around. He came here to win. That guy is playing on a totally different level right now, in clear demonstration there. No fear, knows he's going to land that shot and gets the job done. Cloud9 now two rounds on the board here to TSM's three, but TSM hard eco pretty much from them. They go for the nade, seeing as how Cloud9 have been so aggressive early on. They try to get lucky there, TSM, but it just doesn't pan out for them.
Yeah, and this is full eco here from TSM. They want to build that bank up to get another buy-in, but the momentum really seems to be with Cloud9 at the moment. And I really love that Freakazoid. He's really delivering on some of these entry frags. He's been really, really good. We're going to see him working the P90 again. He can run, and that's the cool thing about the P90. It's kind of like the Tech9, but the almost like, you know, the SMG version Tech9. You can just get so much positioning with it by just pushing forwards and get your riflers up close, get the entries like that. Running around like this is always going to be nice. And,
there's going to be a lot of mind games in this next round between these teams. Cloud9 is thinking, oh, okay, is TSM going to counter our fast mid push? And TSM is also thinking, do we want to commit three players fully towards mid? Or is Cloud9 actually going to do something else?
Something. Yeah, that's actually very, very interesting. Because they actually went three players mid in that round, and Cloud9 still won it with just a simple pop flash play. So this is going to be very interesting indeed. The mind games begin in this grand finals.
You got to love it, right? This is the depth we were looking for. Now the money is starting to grow here on Cloud9 as well, so TSM, a little bit of additional pressure on their shoulders. They need to get something done in this round. They need to stop Cloud9 right here to keep things in control. Cloud9 very quickly setting up once again for A. They've got Skadoodle with that AWP, as always, but the early smokes are going to go down, and TSM, they want to slow down the pace at least a little bit here. This is tricky, though. We're going to have a little bit of a sneaky play as Zipnix gets flashed in through the smoke. He doesn't have his teammate, however, takes that spray battle one for one, and then Shrouded Nothing. Quick exchange there, taking out Device.
This is huge, though. Kerrigan's in position. He can save this round for the Danes. He just has to be quick and clean with these frags, and he'll get the first one. And the rest of Cloud9 is stuck behind the smoke. There's no refrag. Cloud9 are having issues now, but it is still a 2-on-2. It is still doable, and there is still a lot of time for them to play with and to calm things down, to chill, and that's what they're going to do. The rotation comes in, and they split up TSM. Cloud9 still looks strong.
This all comes down to the timing now. Who's going to hit this shot when they come around the corner? And Cajun B spots Sean Gare's gun barrel. No time for Sean Gares to react in that situation, and Freakazoid getting spotted in mid as well. So with 40 seconds left, it's now down to Freakazoid in a 1v2 situation to find a bomb plant or both kills, and it's just not gonna happen. Cajun, perfect positioning, in the right place at the right time in both scenarios.
And I really like that answer from TSM. They said to Cloud9, okay, you can take mid, but we're gonna take A main.
It's actually interesting, though, because I feel like Cloud9 maybe a little bit too much adrenaline, because they could have actually crossed at the same time and given a refrag opportunity, because you know a CT should be challenging there. And they gave two one-on-ones to TSM there. So maybe could have played that a little bit better, but 4-3 is the score now. TSM reclaiming some momentum, but Device on a CZ. Cloud9 still with a pretty big bite, and it's already going to be an opening. Nice defensive kill by Dupree, and still a main control, a sought after here by the Danes, and that's what they are going to get.
Yeah, definitely not expecting that. Nothing all by his lonesome over there in A. All three players here for Cloud9 starting to push up mid, and they're looking for somebody to peek their nose out, but Device with the CZ75 will land the headshot on Shroud, and here's the shift back towards TSM. It was a bit messy in the last round, but they're definitely looking better here. Now down to Skadoodle and Freakazoid, the last two alive for Cloud9. Freakazoid holding that angle, gonna get peeked here by Device, who continues to pressure. And with a minute left here, Cloud9, they've got a lot of work ahead of them if they want to get back into this.
Yeah, it's very interesting here, and maybe they can still make some damage. Well, it's not going so well at the moment. Freakazoid gets tanked down very low by the CZ, and now KGB's turned his attention towards the connector areas. Oh, very clean kill on Skadoodle there. That is beautiful. And this should be flawless now for TSM, and The last kill's a little bit hard to get, and I like how Freakazoid are trying to prolong this a little bit. But there you go. They'll clean it up, and do they go back to the fast mid-takes again? Because they are spotting so much aggression. TSM put three players in A every time that they went A. Pretty impressive.
Yeah, TSM just playing so smart right now. They're letting Cloud9 take mid, and they're just gaining control of A main instead. And that just puts Cloud9 in such an awkward position.
Yeah, we saw that replay right there. Nothing. Caught out. Nobody there to back him up. Cloud9 had three guys waiting over there. It was a 1-3-1 setup from them, and they just get hard countered. So now it's going to come down to Cloud9 to shift things up. It's going to have to wait till the next round, however, because Cloud9 currently on pistols. That was the round that TSM needed. They had only survived with two in the round before it, but having five players alive there, they reset Cloud9's economy. This is TSM's big chance to just get that stranglehold going now on Cloud9. So Cloud9, they need to at least get a bomb plant here, but if they can get a couple of kills just to keep TSM honest, that would be great.
Yeah, and they're doing the smart thing here, which is the kind of the 2-1-2 again and just playing it really passively. They know that Cloud9 don't have much cash to play with, and it's very likely that they'll see an eco like this. So sticking to the sights, making sure no quick bomb plant can actually happen, and that's exactly what is going to go in favor of TSM. They push in, they can't make it happen, rifles are too strong, and this looks like another clean round for TSM. That is really good for their bank at the moment. That's so much security on the CT side.
And it's going to be really interesting to see what Cloud9 will do now. They notice that it's very hard for them, even though they take mid. Will they just try to go for a straight up execute? We will see.
Yeah, that's the curious. Now that's what we have to wonder. Or are they going to put more players into A main right now just to see if they can't once again come out ahead if TSM try to take control there? It does seem like there is quite a group moving over towards A right now for Cloud9, but it might be more of a mid boost or a double mid boost, maybe just fast into mid. Because TSM are also making moves over here, and we do have a man currently lurking over in the smoke by connector, and this is going to get very interesting. Shroud on high, Freakazoid taking point.
Now this is interesting. Do TSM push for info? Will Cloud9 slow the pace down to try to force that and try to punish it from TSM? Well, they won't get an opportunity. It's straight in for the B split play, straight down vent, straight into the bomb site, and here it is. Karrigan starts working on them with that AWP, but he only gets one before the refrag comes in. Cajun B will slow things down for Cloud9, as now they're stuck in the checkers area, although the smoke on CT will help them get across to the site, but this is a very hard situation here for Cloud9. They're outmanned, and the bomb is still not down.
Very well done there by Nothing. Using the flash, that was a very, very likely spot for Device to be holding from. He will be able to get the bomb plant now. And his teammates still have control of checkered. So we see now how TSM are going to go about this retake. Shroud waits, spots the first man, and that's actually plugging things up. Two players there, and TSM just winning duel after duel. Skadoodle trying to hold his own. Not going to be able to pull it off, however. Cajun B there to get the final kill, and three players survive at the end of the round for TSM, who just continue to carry on. A seventh round now for them.
Yeah, Cloud9 going for the fast B split there. I think they waited a bit too long in mid because the rotation was already at a B site when the actual push came in. They traded one for one with Kerrigan on the site, which is good. However, they just took too long for them to get that bomb down on the site.
Actually, I wanted to see them actually, because of that delay, you can kind of like trick the rotation a bit by actually boosting people back out of checkers. Because you can put a lot of pressure on that player and then go back out mid, and you can see some funky stuff. But that's so hard to call in the moment. And I think they really thought that that was a sure thing, that B bomb site. But really nice opener from Karrigan, and here we go into the next round. Full buy up here, but not many nades for Cloud9.
That's actually now exactly here we go. Karrigan also being pretty unpredictable as to where he's setting up with this AWP. Is he connector? Is he B? Now he happens to be waiting here watching A main, so it's going to get a little sneaky here for Cloud9. They do have a couple of smokes to try and cut him out of the picture, and a couple of flashes as well, so we'll see how those get put to use. But TSM, three players here on the A site, they're going to be in position to stop this push once it comes in or play for the retake. A lot of this is going to come down to whether Kerrigan can hit his shots. He's going to get that incendiary out, follow up HE as well, and now it's all about getting that crosshair in play, but Nothing is not happening. He shuts them down immediately, and Shroud coming through big as well. Man advantage now for Cloud9, and they are just taking the fight to TSM, not letting him get set up for a retake.
Yeah, bomb's down, but Dupree's going to come into a situation where there's nobody to help him out. The first kill might be a bit of a surprise here, but no, there is somebody facing. Dupree will get the frag, though, and there is still some time for him to make this one work. Shroud a turnaround, but Skadoodle's on top of it, and Dupree will go down, and it's going to be a nice round for Cloud9. That is very important for them to bring this back straight away and not build too much momentum for their opposition.
Very key for Cloud9 in that round that the gang quad didn't get a single kill. They just traded him right away.
That Nothing frag was ridiculous.
I mean, the nades there, yes, but yeah, Kerrigan, the fact that he was so late getting that crosshair in play, they were already set up and waiting for him. That peek, Nothing, yeah, just snaps him up quick. Skadoodle attempts the shot, perhaps. Tries to back off and change up his play. Doesn't want to hang around once that smoke goes down. And now Dupree. He's trying to go for some shenanigans over in the B halls, but Cloud9 nowhere to be found. Only the soul man, Sean Gare, is on the lurk, and that's exactly what he wants to be doing. Out on the extremities, trying to make it a little bit more difficult for TSM to predict where the main push is going to be coming, because, hey, it's going to the pointy letter right now, onto the A site.
Yeah, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Back in with the A push here for Cloud9. As he actually went all the way to Koch. KCGP's like, what the hell's going on? Shroud is so far pushed up there. And Sipnix is on the bomb site. He needs something, but he finds nothing. And that'll be the death of him. So now Cloud9 with the bomb site. And TSM this time will go for the three-man save. So what a round. Cloud9 finding a lot of success here on this A bomb site.
That's so smart by the Cloud9 player who pushed towards Koch. If you go towards the A site, you see no one at short, you know they're just going to stack the site, which means you have an opening to actually push towards C to spawn and catch the rotation from B off guard, and that's exactly what happened.
That was very nicely done, and once again, I mean, the man holding Zipnix there, that was just nothing. Stepping in, he's delivering those key frags to open up that A site. In the last round versus Kerrigan and this one versus Zipnix, they just aren't able to shut him down. He's very quick right now. So a fifth round on the board now for Cloud9, who are slowly but surely bringing it back, bringing themselves back into this map after a bit of a bumpy start there.
So what's the threat? What do you think is like the minimum rounds that Cloud9 want to aim for here?
It's so hard to call on cash. Maybe you want to at least get up to 7-8.
All right, so you're relatively even then. Okay, so there's still a ways to go here for Cloud9. Now, again, mind games come into play.
The man in question right there, Sean Gare, is talking, so he's got something in mind.
So is it the A again? Again, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Is that mentality going to apply? Are TSM going to overreact? Let's see.
Do they change it up? Do they change up the style? They're still going over towards A, but they're going to change their approach right now. And this is going to be a little bit tricky. TSM, they have to see this coming. And they do have a man in position who can deal with this device by Forklift. He's going to have eyes on the main point for Cloud9 to be trying to hit on this site. But the Molotov there, this is perfect. Cloud9 force him out into the open. Great flashes as well. And just so fast a strike, but Sipnix at least takes a man with them.
Here we go, we've got device moving into play. They're actually not doing too badly here. Lots of delay. Frags bombed down at the back of the bomb site. This is disastrous now here for Cloud9. They've just had Skadoodle left against four players, and that is surely not going to happen. And I actually think this was a super smart round from Cloud9, because they actually... So if TSM went with an A main push, as they've done previously, which is a good way to counter the A main rush, then everyone coming out of Squeaky then would trap them in A main, and then all the CTs are out of position, you get a bomb plant, and you probably kill those two players for free. So I actually think that was super smart by Sean Gares.
Yeah, very simple and cool call there from Cloud9, just doing the same push towards that A side. Maybe not the same push, but just changing the pattern so they cannot make their read onto that round, and TSM just with a good A defense that round.
Yeah, solid work from Device. I mean, the key frag basically picking back the man who got into quad boxes and holding it from there, but now it looks like Cloud9 shifting back towards mid. It's the boost again. Cajun B up in the vent, so we'll see if the Skadoodle's going to shut him down so quickly this time. No EWP for Skadoodle, though, so it's going to make things a little bit more tricky. Cajun, perfect job. Pounces. Not going to get the second, though. Sean Gare's there. Just barely hangs in, so he's got a man advantage now on his team. Cloud9 still with a minute 10 left on this clock. This is plenty of time to make TSM sweat, to make them wonder where exactly the push is going to be coming from this time.
Now, last time we saw TSM in this position, they put one to a bomb site, and Device will find a frag onto Sean Gares, but they still don't know exactly what's going on for Cloud9. They could be anywhere at the moment. They are going to put two players towards A, and it looks like that's actually going to be a good decision, because in comes Cloud9, Device by Forklift. He's going to get taken down for free by Shroud. Really good, really strong entries here, and that should be the bomb down. But TSM can still try to go for this retake. There is kits on both players. There was also an Incendiar and Dupree. These could play very heavily into this retake.
Exactly right, because there it is. Nothing gets forced out into the open. Great use of Incendiary so far by TSM, but a good shot there by Shroud to take Dupree off of the high, off of heaven. And then Zipnix falling as well. Shroud, huge round from the man in question, the man on your screen right there. And that's what's going to be get Cloud9 right back into this game.
A great clutch there from Cloud9. I really like the delay of the planter for TSM, letting them set up for that retake. However, just Shroud is winning the clutch.
That's it right there, man. Once you hit those shots, Henry G put it well. You know, if you can have all the strats in the world, but if you aren't getting the kills, they aren't going to do anything for you. And now TSM, once again, backs to the wall here in the 15th round. Force buy from them. Three rifles, two pistols, good nade count, but only a single kit on Cajun B. Whereas Cloud9, they have everything they need. Shonger is even going for the P90.
But we've seen this situation many times over. Perfect pop flash from a teammate of Dupree, and it could all go TSM's way. That's two frags for the Danes, but that's going to be it. KGB needs to hold. He needs to delay enough for his teammates to come in to give him a hand here. He is, of course, in a very hard position with just a CZ, but Cloud9 are slowing down. These grenades are hurting the push, and The threat of a flank is also quite painful here for Cloud9. What do they do? It looks like Squeal's going to be jumping up into the vent. Very interesting stuff here from Cloud9. Now, with the weapon advantage, but being a man down, this is anyone's.
Yeah, they don't try to force it, Cloud9. They're willing to wait and see if they can't catch somebody out of position here on TSM's part. TSM, once again, spreading that defense out, and the man in question, Skadoodle, has been spotted in vent. So that element of surprise is gone. Now it's going to come down to the straight shots, and TSM falling back to the science as well, 2-2. So this is where it gets a bit tricky here for Cloud9. I do like the fact that they are staying grouped, they're staying together, so they're going to be able to really exchange those frags quickly, get onto a site fast, get that bomb plant, and it looks like it's going to be short. 30 seconds left, though, so they are starting to run out of time. But they still have a smoke and a good use, actually good number of nades here to make this work for them.
This is going to have to be so clutch. Skadoodle comes in, perfect timing for the flank. He will spray down Zipnix. Now he just has to survive as Device looks for the frag. Oh, oh, instant entry from Freakazoid, and that should be the bomb down. And 3-on-2 with the is the situation for Cloud9, and they have these Danes heavily outgunned. TSM looking to get the retake happening with a CZ and a Thanos. In goes Kerrigan, and down straight away. Now it's KJB's time as he looks to try and fight at first the first entry. But these three players are trying to hide, trying to delay. Nice frag there from KJB. Gets the first one, knows there is somebody around quad, goes for the spray, oh, has to reload, there's nothing left for him to do. And that round was so clutch by Cloud9.
Yeah, sick read there. When they saw that there was no one peeking short, you can almost be certain that there's going to be a player playing the car position. And then they just, two players going towards that A site, made it the gas car, peek towards them. And then we see Skadoodle here flanking that player. Just excellent team play there from Cloud9, giving them that win, because otherwise I think TSM just did an excellent B defense and then just went back to good positions.
Cajun B in particular, that man is insane with the CZ-75. Got a kill on B site and then comes in and actually manages to pick up a kill going into the retake on A as well from ranges that you really shouldn't be able to actually just get those kills so consistently with that machine pistol. So going into the next round now, TSM, they still have the round lead. 8 rounds for them, 7 for Cloud9. Quite a few Kevlar actually picked up here for TSM. Kerrigan doing, well, basically this is Kerrigan's calling card. Tech 9 straight up, no Kevlar. He just wants the running gun. But he does have the single smoke, so we'll see where he decides to use that.
And no raid boss actually, which is a little surprising. But either way, it will be a strong pistol. And we have the 3-man push there towards the A side for Cloud9. Not going to really give them all that much. Nothing straight out in the open. There's a smoke leg will go down to help him out, but still a free kill from Kerrigan. TSM are rolling into the B bomb site, and the red carpet has been unleashed, as they will get a free plant for 2 frags as well. So Cloud9 with a very difficult retake on their hands.
That was a perfect timing to hit there for TSM catching Cloud9. Oh, wow, what a shot from Shroud, though. Removes Dupree from the board. Well, now man advantage. They still have control of the kit. That's Skadoodle who has it, and they're going to try and press it into this site, but Device is there, and the crossfire is established. The Danes just holding the line. KJB finds Shroud, and that leaves Skadoodle alone, trying to find the last kill, but it's not meant to be. Device there to end his party, and that's the pistol round going to TSM, and that starts them off strong here in the second half.
And I think it's crucial for Cloud9 to not go for the force by now, because they really want that op on Skadoodle. If they go for the force by, they almost have to win the force by for it to be worth it. Doesn't matter if they get 4 or 5 kills.
And they've actually lost both pistols now. So, this is actually what really impressed me by Cloud9, was actually getting so many rounds despite losing the pistol. And here we go, they do go for the force. So there you go, you put the expectation. This needs to be a delivery of a round win. That's a nice bit of damage, but Stroud gets caught just trying to retreat. And Cloud9 now need to go for a retake of B. This is a good fast round from TSM, and it could very well be Cloud9 losing this one very soon.
Yeah, I want them to back off. There you go, Sean Garris. Back off, hold on to this gear, make it work for you in the next round. You got overwhelmed this time, fine. Just go ahead and take a step back and hold on to the money and the money that you invested here in this round.
That's actually a really good point. Sometimes I think teams underestimate the fact that you can actually use the force buy in 2 rounds rather than just 1.
You try and force it, or you're trying to think, oh, well, if we can only get a rifle, right, and hold on to a rifle or get a kill. But there's no chance of you actually winning this round, not with 5 players alive for TSM in the B site, all with the crossfires established. That's just not going to happen. Yep. So this is very wise here by Cloud9. Back off, see if you can't get it right in the next round.
Actually, part of the interesting thing as well for TSM is that they actually bought up all AKs. And one of the reasons why, and that actually makes me think that they expected an eco and not a force buy. Because if you go for the SMGs and the nades, that allows you to more easily deal with all these situations. And then they have a strained economy. They might not be buying helmets on the CT side. And then the SMGs are still really good. And you set yourself economically up very, very well. So I think, the expectation was more economical play, as you suggested, Threat. So they're probably thinking, the same thing, that Skedule is the most dangerous thing here. He's probably going to get put on the AWP straight away, but that's not really going to happen now unless he gets a lot of frags and somehow can just buy it naked.
Yeah, and that's the problem. If you're going to go for that light first weapon round where you have four M4s, light armor, and a few nades, it's very hard to win that round without losing a lot of players, which means the next round you just have to win that one. Otherwise, TSM is going to get up to 5-6-1 in the half.
So we'll see how this pans out, and look at this. This is what Cloud9 were getting ready for. Molotov going down, forcing off of the boost, and I think that they managed to catch just a couple of players out there for Cloud9, so TSM have an idea of what Cloud9 are throwing at them. Dupree holding the line with the UMP as well. Very effective SMG to have at any range. Great for tapping, great for up close and dirty work. And it's a counter boost, but Zipnix is ready for this. He already sees it, the wall bang in as well. Songares is gonna burn, but Skadoodle is there to get the kill right back. Dupree going to work though, second kill for him.
Yeah, this is looking pretty good from TSM. I like this anti-eco so far. Cloud9 going with that mid pressure and being punished for it. So as we have them still trying to make it work, Skadoodle's actually pushed into the mid warehouse. And Shroud is going over, but TSM are so aware, and they're glued together at this point. It's like they've attached a rope to one another, they're climbing a mountain, they're not separable at all, and Cloud9 are into the retake. They must make this work. In goes nothing, quick frag, heading to the second one. Oh! Seville finishes off Dupree, and all of a sudden, we got a round on our hands.
This is it. Device now has to play, he has to play it perfectly. He's going to be able to take out Skadoodle, but we're into a 2-on-2, make it a 2-on-1. The rifle's going to work, but nothing gets caught out by Device. And it comes down to Shroud now versus Device. Device positional advantage for him. Can play quad boxes, gets the flick, gets the kill. And Cloud9 come way too close for comfort there in that round to upsetting TSM.
Very risky to go for that hidden plant in that position. Just imagine if nothing would have had a kit.
Oh, this is, yeah, exactly. Device, he's forced out there, you're right, to take that fight. And nothing, I don't know if he was expecting it to be that quick, because he did seem to be caught out a little bit out in the open. And then just such a difficult situation there for Shroud. It's a 50-50 guess. Is he going left? Is he going right? Which way is he going to go? And Device just catches him off guard. But now we see that force buy. And Skadoodle can't afford the op. Probably due to that like one kill that he actually got on the man in quad. That $300 could have made the difference. But he's got a glass cannon. So we'll see if he can actually find that opening kill that he was so good at getting versus Fnatic earlier.
Yeah, he is truly naked right now. But it is Skadoodle after all. And he just has to connect those shots.
There,
and
it,
there
is.
It is. He finds one of the Dupree.
Ooh, unreal.
That's a nasty little tag as he gets the retreat back to the bombsite itself. But that's the job he needed to do. And he's actually reinforced here as well. There is very limited mid presence from Cloud9. However, TSM have opted to give it up and just go for a play into A main. And Sean Gez is there towards the crowd, towards the MBK position here, just nestled up next to that smoke into the corner. He needs to deliver here for his team if they want to hold this one off. But there is some lots of good grenades here from TSM. Sean Gez forced out, does get the frag. Freakazoid instantly taken down, and TSM with a clean entry almost, it would seem, as the bomb will go down by Device. And in comes Cloud9.
There it is, the peak, and Skadoodle, he had the opportunity there. Not able to hit that shot though, so it's going to be that 3-on-3. Messi misses the step out, but then nothing's there to save the day. Shroud gets one as well. And that leaves it now down to Sipnix. Bomb ticking away, running out of time. Peaks at the perfect time to take out nothing. And Skadoodle, can he actually land this shot? Doesn't have a kit, so he's forced. He has to run forward. He has to land the big kill, but he's not going to do it. Sipnix playing this perfectly. Gets overwhelmed in the end. But will not have the time. He needs to find it. He's going to get his gun, and he's going to hightail it out of there. What a hold from Sipnix. Every second was so valuable in the end for TSM.
Hey, did he get the AWP away? Yeah, I think he did.
Flawless play there from Sipnix. It's still a very hard position to make that clutch, even though it's a 3v1.
Yeah.
When he's playing that quad position, you don't have a kit. You have to push or force yourself upon him. It's just very, very difficult, especially considering they had an AWP.
I was going to say, they actually saved the AWP, and now they can force buy behind it. And this is really interesting. It feels like a marginal situation, but they can't really eco. That would put TSM up to like 13, 14 rounds. So they're just going to go for it here, Threat. Here it is. To be that flashes through, and they are going to be the ones doing the fast mid take, and there is not much resistance from Cloud9 just yet, playing a very passive setup here. And already Kerrigan is finding frags onto Skadoodle, so that's the AWP out of the picture. Sean Gez falls as well, and now it looks like TSM have busted this force buy.
That's pretty much it, exactly. You can have a quick rotation onto upper from nothing, but that's not going to be enough to hold back TSM. And unfortunately for them, that AWP, it's not possible for Cloud9 to pick it up.
And the weird thing is, we have to go back to that second round force buy. The first weapon round, they didn't have any nades. They had a glass cannon up on Skadoodle. It came down to a 1v1 with Sipnix playing the quad position. Just imagine if they would have had more nades, Skadoodle would have had that Kevlar. Maybe they would have won that round. Now they went for another force buy. They haven't even got a single full buy on this half yet.
Yeah, that's the main issue right now.
And that's actually how Cloud9 were able to take down Fnatic or Mirage. It's the same situation. And right now, looks like they are getting hunted like wild animals.
No saving here. Yeah. Gotta go with the Kerrigan. He gets a little ahead of himself that time, though. Runs out of bullets, and that's gonna cost him. Shroud roasting alive, trying to play out the time. He steps out, and he's just... Did he get a... No, okay, he got the kill on device earlier. I was about to say, that last split second there, if he found the headshot, I would have lost it.
It feels like now they're actually committed to more force buys as well, and that's kind of the slippery slope of always being on force buys. You may never get the money out there to have the full buy if you keep losing, but if you do win that one key round, it's kind of almost the gambler's thing, but... We have the AK, so that should encourage it. And Spiel's back with the AWP. He's even got Kevlar now.
Yeah, he's got Kevlar now and a kit. Two kits, in fact. So there will be time. And Cloud9 now going for a bit more of a standard setup here on the A site. Three players, in fact, completely giving up mid. They really want to stack up the defense here. TSM, they went fast this time, but then they light it up. And I was about to say, Freakazoid, where are you? He shows up big, gets two kills, and stops the TSM push.
Oh my god, Freakazoid saved Skadoodle there, who missed that shot, and it is going to be Device and KGB in to try and just bully them off this bomb site, but it's not going to happen here. The bomb is down in the choke point, and Device is alone. He's got four members of Cloud9 to eliminate, and I don't think that is in the playing cards at the moment. As, don't count Cloud9 out of this one yet. So it looks like this was, I think, the closest we've seen to a proper buy from them.
Yeah, and see how easy it was as soon as they got a full set of nades. They're actually gonna, they might even survive with four players. So just imagine if they just had gone for that extra full eco earlier in this half. Now it's already 13-7 in favor of TSM.
That was key as well.
Yeah.
Not losing more than one player. And you can see that they were going for that economic damage. So there is still a chance, indeed.
No doubt about it. Freakazoid, though, he stood tall this time around. Double spray down for him. Nearly gets a third as well. Device dropped down to 30 HP just off of that single spray. Very well done. Great position. And now it gets interesting. Cloud9, they have a double op set up. They got one of those for free off of Device. Thank you, sir. So it's going to come down to whether TSM can pull off this force or not. Three rifles, two Tech Nines, great nade count. Looks like a turn of speed in mind here for the Danes.
If there's no bomb plant from TSM, this round could be 13-10 for Cloud9. This means a lot to their comeback, to their momentum. It's all on this round for them. And will the double AWP actually deliver? Now TSM, they've got a couple of Tech Nines, so you're wanting to see an execute in a spot like this from them.
And Kerrigan, I mean, Kerrigan's got that Tech Nine. He would have probably dropped an AK to a teammate and just stuck with the Tech Nine. He's so good at getting headshots with that pistol.
They're walking into a stack here in mid. This is going to be very tough for TSM.
Comes down to whether they can land the shots again, but Sandbags and Shroud with the crossfire attempt. The nades are going on to that A site now, and the push begins. Freakazoid holding very close. He's waiting for that flash. There it is, but he gets counterflashed as well, and he's completely blind. TSM now, here's the time, but Skadoodle strikes down one. Freakazoid takes one as well. Skadoodle still here, and he gets the kill! Nothing is gone, though, so we're into the two-on-two. But that kill right there, that made the difference. This is feasible for Cloud9. Skadoodle coming in big.
This is absolutely crazy right now. Shroud goes down to Dupree onto the bomb site, and that bomb can now finally be planted. The clock can be set onto Sean Gares as he moves in. Now, they don't know where he is, but he's got an AWP here as well. This is not necessarily the easiest weapon to do this with, but he's moving in slowly but surely. And TSM, they just have to play this perfect. Sean Gares needs an instant kill the moment he sees a player. Here it is, the first phase. Shot, but still, Dupree's in with a backstab, and that's exactly how it's done. What a crazy round there.
So many sick individual performances that round. First from Skadoodle, then from Dupree getting three kills. Just great execution towards that A site, but it was all Dupree.
Yeah, that was exactly. Dupree taking point and getting the job done. Skadoodle coming very close, and Shroud just going straight through that smoke. No fear on him. Definitely want to try to catch that planter. Out of position, but it didn't work out that time for Cloud9. They will be able to get another force buy, but there's no AWP for Skadoodle. He's limited to the M4. Whereas TSM, they have the op. They have everything they need here to ruin Cloud9's day and get up onto map point. So this is it.
Yeah, it'd be incredible if they managed to come back from this position down on the chips, quite literally, as there's no money left really in the coffers. And there is Vixor getting flashed in, and I really liked in the previous round how Cloud9 did the perfect play against the rush, against the nades, but actually TSM did the perfect counterflash that you can always throw in to actually break that, so
it was
very nicely
well done. It was very well done by TSM. Freakazoid could have wreaked havoc. Two guys were full flash there.
Yep.
He would have gone to town.
That would have been the round, for sure.
Yeah, that one flash from TSM Very well done on their part. And now we get into the thick of things here because we're at 50 seconds, so it's about that time now for TSM to make up their minds. And, well, dying isn't part of it. Skadoodle, he removes Zipnix from the map already, but TSM going to speed up towards this B site, and Sean Garris, he's going to actually hear these steps. He's going to be able to stand his ground and actually find the shot. They're in check it. They're right there, and there's the first kill. Manages to drop the bomb carrier. Not going to get the second, however. That's going to be nothing. Skadoodle coming in as well, and a perfect hold for Cloud9 to keep themselves alive.
Yeah, excellent defense there and great positioning there with the C-side. Very key that he survived with four players, which means they might build a small bank. However, seeing as they didn't have a lot of nades, they might actually be forced on eco if they lose this, because they really need all the nades they can get.
Yeah, it's going to be very, very incredible to see them actually make this work. I mean, Skadoodle's back on the AWP. We've seen that he's not been as hot as he has been in some moments prior in this tournament, but this is where the kind of pre-rate JW brought out form, and Skadoodle's looking to get a shot on, and they're going close with the pistols, misses the no-scope, only gets a tag on Zipnix, and that is really devastating. Any bit of damage is definitely very potent here for TSM, but it looks like Sean Gares is going to control the situation, and in comes Freakazoid. He's able to do some damage as well. So two players dead here for Cloud9, but that's not the end of the world as they go 14-10.
Very nice full eco though from TSM. They're going for a full Glock eco, just a straight up YOLO A rush, getting two kills. Skadoodle, I think maybe Skadoodle expected them to go for the buy, because otherwise I don't think he would have made that peak initially, but still a very nice eco from TSM.
Very risky stuff. But you got to give credit to Sean Gares as well, not overcommitting. Just waiting, biding his time, holding that angle, not letting them get onto the site. So no bomb plant, no additional money coming out here for TSM to work with. And so it is going to be a bit of a quasi-buy for them. Tech-9s, Kevlar, and a few nades to work with, whereas nothing goes charging into B-Halls. Goes for the spray battle, and he's still here. Shroud there to save the day. Talk about teamwork. Now it comes down to Kerrigan and Cajun B. Two guys still alive and looking for those shots. I mean, Kerrigan and Cajun both getting one. And Cajun now looking for the man in Toxic.
More damage would be really, really nice here. He's definitely looking for a headshot, but Shroud will take him down. Shroud, the savior that round. That was an incredible save. I mean, that push from nothing, that could have been a disaster.
Yeah, very cool play there from Cloud9 going in for the three-man aggression towards Toxic, just trying to gain some map control. I don't think they expected a Tech 9 armor buy. However, it's very nice that TSM actually went for the kind of double eco, because it means they can have a lot of nades on this round. As we can see, four smokes and a full set of AKs.
Yeah, exactly, full set of AKs, which means that they can really turn on the speed here. They're not going to rely on that AWP to create an opening for them. And anti-rush flash is going out as well. They don't want Skadoodle to get in there and get a free pick or Freakazoid. Instead, it's going to be Cajun getting headshot. There's the effective trade, however, nothing. Steps in, picks up a kill, brings it back to a 4-on-4, but the damage is on Cloud9's side. They've taken quite a bit here. Skadoodle down to 64 and nothing. Not much health here.
I really like how Cloud9 actually had three players towards the A site at the period where the push on B storage came in, because that could have otherwise been the cue for TSM to just barrel into that A bomb site, thinking, oh, okay, they're pushed there, they'll have less players on the defense on A, this could be a vulnerability. But Cloud9 locking it down, we got a sick position here, what an off angle that is, and nothing could absolutely decimate them here as they move in. Oh, the peak is a little bit too soon, and nothing goes down for free, and that's a 4-on-3 now in favor of TSM as they march onto the B bomb site. Shroud comes in with the M4 in hand, looks for their shots, gets one, and almost a second, but the smoke will go down and the cross is going to happen. But Shroud9, Shroud once more gets the frags.
What?
T-Kill comes in as well, and oh my goodness, Cloud9 win the round. I don't believe my eyes. It happened though, and they are on the comeback trail.
I bow down to Shroud.
After that kill onto nothing when it was hiding in that super weird spot towards T-Spawn, I was sure that they were going to pick up the round. But Shroud threw the smoke.
Yeah, this is insane. Look at this. He does so much damage. Nearly takes out Device, and then it's just a matter of stepping in there. He gets the angle right with the Tech 9 as well, and then Kerrigan just felt generous. Wanted to help out a little bit.
Yeah, he could play this map blindfolded, just running around. He just knows every angle.
Absolutely insane. And now it's going to be pistols here. Skadoodle hits the shot mid-air. He's out hunting right now. Goes to town with the pistol as well. Still managing to get one kill, but nothing drops fairly low. And Shroud and Sean Gares, they're going to have to just wait for the cavalry here. Let TSM get that bomb plant. Don't rush things. Line them up instead, Shroud, and you know, just go ahead, buddy. Get a couple more kills on the board.
It's always scary, isn't it? Kerrigan picked up an AWP. I'm like, oh my goodness, this could turn bad. But Shroud is he's on the warpath at the moment. This is very, very crazy. And Cloud9.
One thing to note, though, is there's a lot of players dying every single round here from Cloud9, which means as soon as they lose a round, TSM will get to 15, and Cloud9 will have a very weak buy.
Yeah, I've got to look at the money. Although there's yeah, 10 grand on Ska.
Yeah, they're actually pretty stacked. I'm surprised.
Yeah, I definitely assumed they would be a little bit more broke as well, Cloud9, but they're very close to bringing this back. TSM, now is a big buy for them. Device with that AWP, we'll be seeing if he can actually pick up anything here. But he was hoping for a bit of a short push. That's not going to happen. So things stabilize. Now both of these teams not willing to throw it away, although we do have a bit of an interesting play coming in here. Zipnix, is he going to get this right? There's the pop blast, bone blast, and Freakazoid needs to land a spray. Zipnix, how is he doing? He hits the headshot there. Half blind, and he gets the kill. Not acceptable, Freakazoid. You cannot miss a shot like that.
Okay, now this is a really hard position to be in. Just as Fred said, this got, okay, got even worse, guys.
This is
soul
shattering. This is shattering. Cloud9, this round right here.
They need to save. They want two weapon rounds to work with now.
They need everything they can get. If Shroud and Shangirs can somehow dodge everybody or kill them all, one or the other works. A nice HE into the group will do some good damage, but it's not going to be good enough. And Shangirs gets overwhelmed. Shroud now, he's the last man alive. He's been doing some crazy
he's
stuff.
He's going for it, guys.
This is a bit much. Well, they are low.
He's
they
going
are low,
for it.
And the bomb isn't planted yet, but he doesn't know just how low. Zipnix, Cajun Beef, Kerrigan, everybody. He has no idea.
Yeah, that's actually quite funny. When I saw him running, I'm like, this guy, who knows, he might just go in there and just try to kill all of them, even though it doesn't make much sense. He could go for it, and, well, looks like Cloud9 are in a very, very scary position indeed. They had the comeback happening. The last round was disastrous. They're getting picked to pieces. They couldn't make any plays at all. And it looks like TSM have really got this sorted out at the moment, but...
Yeah, they have to drop two weapons this next round, so they have one real full buy. If they would win that one, well, yeah, they are up on 15. They can't lose, yeah.
They're good. Yeah. They're good. Yeah, they can't lose now, but they have enough to get a full buy here. That's a play that Freakazoid is going to be having nightmares about, though. Win or lose, he's going to be thinking back to that one, saying, I had that in the bag. He was dead to rights. What happened? Yeah, how did we not see it? Like, Freakazoid.
He didn't get flashed.
No, he just puts some shots into the wall, I think. He lands one bullet. No, he gets him down to 22, but still.
I'd love to see his pov in that, actually. That looks really weird.
That's brutal. But the full buy now for Cloud9. This is where it gets fun. All on the line. Can TSM close it here, or can Cloud9 take it to a 30th round? Feels like Cloud9, it's in the rule books. Like, it's either overtime or 30 rounds. They can't actually win clean.
Yeah, exactly. And we actually get a big mid presence from Cloud9. Even though it's not very aggressive, there's three players in the vicinity. So TSM need to be careful that they don't overstep and that they actually go in and not go going together and not one for one. Use the grenades. Or Device can just open up if he can find that fine angle. The AWP, and he's looking for it.
I think he saw on the trajectory of the nade that there's actually one guy at Sandbags.
And we know they have the nades for that, the Molotovs, so if he can actually get them into position to throw them, this could be a bad opening for Cloud9 again.
He is taking the Sandbags angle here, hoping. There are the flashes, and now begins the push. Cloud9, see if they can support. There's Shroud to open things from the vents, manages to pick up the kill on Zipnix to start. Nothing still lurking around here. More flashes going out, trying to buy more time. 40 seconds left on this clock for TSM to make the play. TSM do manage to put a man up in the vents, however, so they can start applying the pressure towards that B site. A nice Molotov there to start. Device opens things up, takes out nothing. That's the man in mid, gone. But a great Molotov here to buy even more time, slowing TSM down further. They're in check, and they're now starting to push onto the site. Shroud, however, the overlapping defense is here, but Kerrigan to open things up. Will trade one for one. Sean Gares takes a peek and gets a double. And that is now going to be Device and Cajun B, the last two alive here for TSM, pressing onto the site with only 10 seconds left. They have to get the job done, but bring around the Rosie. Sean Gares not going to let it happen, and it is now Device. 3 seconds left. No way at all for him to win this round. He has to back off. 30 rounds.
Yeah, amazing play from Cloud9, being three guys in mid, waiting till 40 seconds left. A lot of players would, okay, it's 40 seconds left. Surely they're not going for mid. I can just go for the push, or either I should go back to one of the sites. They just waited. They knew that TSM was going for that mid push.
Absolute madness here. Now we're going into this last one. Who knows what the hell's going to happen from this point. And Cloud9, they've got all the nades to work with as well. They are fully stacked, fully stocked to do all the damage. Get the delay, but it's all going to be about what TSM decide to go for here, because Cloud9 are going for a passive opening, a 2-2-1 play. This is very reactive from Cloud9, and their B defense, actually. They've got the B defenders right on the bomb site, so no info on B storage. So Cloud9, they don't have... The only guy giving information to them is this one close on mid, and it looks like TSM are going to go for that A split with all with the A execute smokes.
Yeah, they're going to just set it up, go with something they've practiced 100 times. They know works. Freakazoid holding back a little bit on that Molotov. Skadoodle and NBK looking for the angle as they try and push out here. Waiting for that further flash, but there's Zipnix taking out Shroud. That was in Vents, that was in mid, but now roasting alive Skadoodle. He's running out of HP, but he gets the one-for-one trade anyway. And now they line up, but it's not going to be good enough. And TSM go crashing onto the A site. They eliminate the defense, and it's down to Sean Gares. 1v4. Cloud9 came so close, but this would be one of the most legendary comebacks in CS history if he were able to pull this off and take his team to overtime. Just not going to happen. Can't see TSM making the mistake. The Vice does not miss, and TSM will pick up the first map.
Oh my god, what a game. What a game Cloud9's delivering there. Just almost delivering the win, but certainly delivering us a feast for the eyes, because that was fantastic.
I mean, is that relief? Is that relief you see on TSM's face there?
Absolutely. I mean, you've always got to be incredibly scared. Like, Cloud9, just the individual skill coming to play from multiple players. Some of those rounds from Shroud were ridiculous. But Skadoodle, I think, you know, not coming out huge. And that last round is the round for Skadoodle to just put his foot down and deliver what we know he can deliver. But there wasn't enough there in that moment.
Yeah, Skadoodle seems to be the master of getting one more kill than he should.
Like the number of situations. It was like Zipnix, actually, on the first side where he was like, one kill. Okay, I get overwhelmed. Skadoodle, though. Every single time. No scopes? That doesn't matter. He just makes it happen.
Yeah, he was burning to death. He had half of a second left to live. He just fires a no scope and just gets a one-for-one trade.
Don't worry, man. Everybody else is wondering this, too. The other guys on the other team right now are wondering, like, how does this guy do it every single time? We're going to go ahead and let you guys ponder that for a few minutes. We're going to take a very short break before we come back for our second map here in the grand finals of the DreamHack Valencia CSGO tournament powered by Faceit.